discuss the anisotropic ape or king. In last lecture, we have discussed about anisotropic ape benzene. In that lecture, we have discussed about that. That is, what is going to be the protons of benzene, which are lie in D-shedding area, zone A. Okay, that is, there are two zones, that is first is shielding zone and the de-shielding zone. Shielding zone is represented by like in holes. Okay, in the same way, today we are going to discuss the anisotropic alkenes. Again, I am going to explain the meaning of anisotropic is that is the non-uniform magnetic field. Then this electrons of or the electrons of the pi orbitals circulate under certain circumstances, they can create their own magnetic field, and that magnetic field is known as the induced magnetic field. Now, whether the induced magnetic field of the direction is it aligns or opposite with the direction of applied magnetic field, there can be three types of the magnetic fields are exist, and this phenomenon is known as the anisotropy. Okay, so let us start with the alkenes. All of you know the structure of the alkenes. Okay, what is the structure of alkenes? For example, we can take the example, that is the ethylene. Okay, what is the structure? It is the double bond C, and here hydrogens. Okay, the hydrogens in the element by nature are called as the protons. Here one is the sigma bond. Okay, and another is the pi bond. Which bond? That is the pi bond. Now, due to the pi bonds of electrons, they can circulate under certain circumstances each other with the electron density with this, and here this, which is the face to face and the opposite direction in 3D dimensional work, and they can create their own magnetic field, that is called as induced magnetic field. Now let us consider the direction of this induced magnetic field by means of a diagram. Okay, see here. C, double bond C. Okay, these are the protons of ethylene. Okay, this is the area. Okay, now the electrons of pi density. Do you know pi density? That the electrons of a pi orbitals revolve around the path that is known as like this. Okay, the direction of the electrons is like this. Here, up to this area, that is up to this area, the direction is from upper side to lower side. And then the electrons pass and turn to this direction, that is in this direction, is called as the shielding area. Called as de-shielding area or zone. In the same way, when the electrons are circulated with pi density here, as like this, when they change their path along this direction as a de-shielding zone. This one, this is a shielded zone. This zone, that is a shielded zone. Okay, this is the direction. Here also, this is the direction. That is, this direction is like this. Okay, and with external magnetic field of strength B0, external or applied magnetic field of strength H0 is applied with the direction of this. At that time, what happens? Within this area, okay, this area and this area, here what happens? The electrons of secondary magnetic field here, electrons of secondary magnetic field here oppose the direction of a applied magnetic field. Okay, therefore at the time in this area when electrons comes, they can oppose with the direction of a external magnetic field. Okay? Also in this direction, up to this direction, there is opposition of a external magnetic field. And what happens here? Two points of the total magnetic fields are parallels, which is of a shielding zone. This is also called as a shielding one. Okay, and another one is called as a, that is on this area is called as a B-shielded zone. That is, due to the development of the secondary magnetic field, whatever made the secondary magnetic field, it can either arise here, and that is here, secondary magnetic field, either it aligns, aligns in what? That is with parallel with applied magnetic field, or perpendicular or opposite to applied magnetic field. These two cases are arise. Why these two cases are arise? That is due to the circulation of the electrons of secondary magnetic field. Already we know that, that is, all the hydrogens or the protons of the alkene are situated in which one? That is in D shielding one. Okay, that is, these protons have the nature that is the D shielded nature. Okay, therefore the alkenes of a protons having the higher delta value, higher delta value. Now when the protons are present in this zone, that is the shielded, and in this shielded zone, at that time these protons are protected from the external magnetic field. Okay, therefore, but actually what happens here, protons are situated in this shielded zone. The protons are de-shielded. Therefore, these protons are called as de-shielding protons. As the protons are de-shielded, therefore delta value goes on increasing. Okay, in shielding zone, what happens? These protons are protected from the direction of the applied magnetic field. Therefore, protons having the lower chemical shift value. Okay, now here one more point is taken to be in mind, that that is, when the external magnetic field is applied to the alkene, at the same time the electrons can circulate in this direction. That is, up to this direction electrons can oppose with this external magnetic field. Up to this direction also they can oppose this electron with the external magnetic field. In this way, what happens here? Total magnetic field is created in between shielded zone and the de-shielded zone. Now, what is the total magnetic field? Suppose here the total magnetic field in shielding zone is equal to B, and the strength of applied magnetic field, it is considered as H0 or it can be considered as a B0. We can write here the total magnetic field in shielding zone, that is equal to that when you fill direction, that is equal to B0. Okay, and opposite nature of the electrons of secondary magnetic field having the same, that is equal to H induced. Therefore, B0 minus H induced, or it may be also written as a B induced instead of this H induced or B induced. Okay, therefore, here some of the less total magnetic field because the protons are shielded from the external magnetic field and the electrons are opposing to this external magnetic field. Therefore, B is equal to B0 minus B induced is equal to total magnetic field in shielding zone. What is about this shielding zone? In this shielding zone, already the direction of circulation of electrons is parallel one. And as this direction is parallel one, therefore there is, we have taken the sum of the strength of applied magnetic field and the strength of a secondary magnetic field. That is when it arrives, at that time total magnetic field is equal to strength of this B induced, okay, plus strength of a applied magnetic field, that is B zero. Then this is of a de-shielded zone. De-shielded zone. Now, here one more point is to be taken, that is when this is the fibers, at that time this rotation of the electrons towards this orbit is to be in this direction. Okay? Now like this direction. Suppose this is A, so double bond C, and here the pi electrons are here, therefore they are circulating in this direction. They are circulating in this direction. They are come in this direction, that is in shielded zone, they can approach with the direction of the external magnetic field. Thus, there at a time exists external magnetic field, then secondary magnetic field, and the total magnetic field due to the shielded and de-shielded zone. Thus, this phenomenon is known as the anisotropy in alkyne. In next lecture, we are going to discuss the anisotropy in alkyne. In alkynes, which are the bonds? Before discussing this, if you have liked my video, please subscribe and share the video. I am just going to remind this in alkyne, that is, all the hydrogens or the protons are lying in between the zone of a de-shielded, therefore, all the protons are called as a de-shielded protons. In other words, already they have a trick, that is DD. DD means de-shielded downfield. That is, downfield means that is the protons having the higher delta value. Okay? Therefore, DD means that is de-shielded downfield. And what is about for the shielding zone? That is the upper field. Paramagnetic upper field. Okay, B shielded downfield, paramagnetic upper field, your shielded upper field. Or it can be also known as a shielded upper field. Okay, thus you can realize whether this zone is called as a shielded zone. And why this one is shielded zone? That is when the direction